So what is yoga? Yoga is one of the six schools of Vedic philosophy after Sankhya. The second school of philosophy is yoga. But literally the word yoga comes from the root word yuj, which means to unite. To unite, we can say body, breath and mind together in the practical aspect of it. But if you actually look at it in a deeper level, it actually means uniting yourself with the divine. So when you're practicing yoga in different forms, we can say asanas, breathing practice, pranayama, all that are helping us to really go from outside to inside, to really feel that unity within ourselves. By practicing asanas, we develop a lot of awareness towards our body. So we know what's happening in our body. We know where we feel the pain, where we feel the stretch. So we have a lot of localized awareness to the body. That's the first level of understanding about ourselves. First, this body. If you're physically ill, you cannot really have intellectual thinking, or you can't really think about super consciousness or where am I coming from. You really can't go beyond your disease if you're physically ill. So first, that's why we have asana component of it, so which will strengthen our body to be really, really strong in our body and to be completely aware of what's going on inside our body. And then we have the breath component, which is again touched upon by pranayama practice. After you understand your body, you can really focus on how your breath is moving, what's happening in your body and what's happening in your breath. When you're actually thinking for a very long time and you're in deep thoughts, your breath becomes very, very slow. So if you know your breath, you can really know your mind, you can really know your thoughts, which kind of thoughts, where it is coming from, what are the quality of your thoughts. So if you really understand where these thoughts are coming from, you can really calm yourself down. You can let go of things which you don't want, you can keep which you really want, and directing all the energy towards inside. So that is what is really yoga, to feel the unity, to feel unity with everything around us.
Namaste, I am Garima Bhandari and I wish you all a very happy International Yoga Day 2018. A lot of people often ask me, what does yoga mean to me? Honestly, for me, yoga now is a way of life. When I first started the Ashtanga yoga practice, I thought that it is a mere physical asana practice. But when I got more in depth into it, I understood that how yoga is not any form of workout, but it is a workout within. A lot of this practice actually helps us connect deeper with ourselves, a lot of self-awareness, and we all get caught in this pandemonium of life, emotions, the highs and lows, the sukha and dukkha. So yoga keeps us centered, and breathing is perhaps the most portable form of yoga, the most portable thing that we can carry with us and take it anywhere, anytime. And that is what yoga practice teaches us. And also it helps me personally clear off the lens that, you know, like I've been wearing, maybe because of the pains I must have witnessed in the past or the worries of the future. So for me, I have got the understanding that happiness is actually in this 6 feet of mat that is there with you. And that is all thanks to my Ashtanga yoga practice. Namaste.
In my very first yoga class about 2.5 years ago, the teacher led us through a series of classical asanas and repeatedly told us to watch our breath. The idea that you had to assume these postures with a sense of steadiness, ease, and deep breaths is what initially captivated me into practicing yoga. I come from a background of absolutely no physical training, be it dance or sport. But I soon realized that it did not matter. All I had to do was show up every day and put in the work. Sometimes we may not have hours and hours to devote to the practice, but even a 5 or 10 minute yoga practice done consistently every day is better than long hours of practice done irregularly. Practice without any attachment, relax, and you will receive.
Yoga, besides making me a happier, independent and a positive person, you know what yoga brought to me? Yoga brought a new outlook towards my own self, the way I was perceiving myself, the way I was regarding myself. And that happened over a period of time. That happened when I put myself on the mat, connected with my own body, connected with my own breath. So I became comfortable in my own skin, and I believe That should happen for every girl and every woman, in fact for every man and every human, that they learn to first regard their bodies as sacred, and they first learn to regard themselves worthy of their own love. So yoga taught me how to be regarding yourself nothing short of divine, nothing short of beautiful, nothing short of completely independent.
All of us want to look good, even I want to look good, but yoga has given me to look at the whole thing in a slightly different way. So I feel looking good is a byproduct, feeling good is the anchor. You need to keep checking if you're feeling good. And that kind of helped me to be more aware of my body and how it moves, how I'm in tune with myself or no. And it also helps me to be more present, more be more here and now. Breath is the anchor for everything that you do in yoga, so it helps me to be more aware of my breathing, and it sort of gives me these glimpses that once in a while breath is the only thing that connects something that's within you and something that's not. So to me, yoga means self-love and self-care, and well, it's been the starting point of this age-old practice, and the journey still continues.
To be in the practice of yoga is a constant and daily process. It's not going to happen over a short period of time. Yoga is a lifestyle. Fully experience the state of yoga, it is something that you need to work on a daily basis. It's not just about going for a 1 hour class and being on the mat. Yoga actually is so much more beyond the mat. The word yoga comes from the Sanskrit word yuj, meaning the union, a beautiful union of the mind, body, soul. It's all about connecting with our inner self. And to me, yoga is truly experienced when I am able to be absolutely present, absolutely in the moment, absorbing each and every moment as much as possible, to be mindful and connected.